When you're developing scripts for use in FDMEE, you can actually do this inside of the web interface itself. So if you select the Setup tab in FDMEE, you'll find that there's a script editor link down here which can be used to develop these scripts. So I'm not going to do any script development here for the moment, but let me show you an existing script that I've already registered here. So I need to select my target application of KT Demo, and I've registered an import script which is available here. And it's a very simple script, as you can see, it consists of 5 lines only. What I want to show you here really is that the script editor that comes with FDMEE leaves a lot to be desired. You can see that there is no colouring to any of my syntax, there is no controls on the toolbar providing assistance with any of the functions or anything like that. It's a very, very simple editor indeed, and as such, it's actually not particularly useful to develop scripts here, and there are better options available. So we're going to talk about a couple of these options during the course. We're going to have a look at a tool called Eclipse, which is a fairly heavy-duty IDE, which we can use to develop and test scripts in. And we're also going to have a look at a second option, which is my personal preference, which is a tool called Notepad++. Notepad++ is a simple text editor, but it provides a lot of features out of the box to help with scripting. So it's going to give us some assistance with colouring, it will give us assistance with the syntax when we're writing scripts, and there is an add-on for Notepad++ which we can use to actually execute our Jython scripts prior to adding them here in FDMEE. So this lets us test the sections of our script in a more controlled and in a more safe environment. So I find it far preferable to trying to develop scripts here directly. Now I'm going to provide direct download links to all of the tools that I mention here, but let me go through the process of setting up Notepad++ for the development of Jython scripts, because it's a really quick and really simple thing to do. So firstly, if I go to a new tab in my web browser, I'm just going to do a search for Notepad++, and you can use your preferred search engine to do this. You see that this gives me the first link here for notepad++.org. And from here, I'll simply need to select the download link on the left-hand side of the screen. Now, I should point out that there is both a 32-bit and a 64-bit version of the software available. I mentioned before, though, that we're going to work with an add-in for Notepad++, which will allow us to execute our scripts offline. And that add-in, unfortunately, is only available for the 32-bit version of Notepad++. So even if you're working in a 64-bit environment, it is actually preferable to download and install the 32-bit installer here. So I'll click the link to download the 32-bit installer. I'll save this to my downloads folder. And once it's downloaded, I can simply click the executable here to run through the options. And you'll see here, I'm just going to run through all of the default options, confirming them. I'm not making any changes to the standard installation options at all. So it takes a moment to install Notepad++, and we have an option here to launch this immediately after installing, which is what I'll do. And this launches what looks like a very simple text editor, but already this is an improvement over what you would get in the FDMEE web interface. If I start a new text file here, you'll see that there's a language menu that's available here. This menu allows you to choose a programming language, and it will then format the code that you enter here according to the syntax of that language. Now you'll see if I have a look under J that there is no specific Jython category here. However, if we look under P, there is a Python category. So if I select this here and I just paste in the script that we saw in the FDMEE web interface, already I hope you can see that this is much easier to read than it was in the web interface. We have colouring to provide assistance with the syntax, and that alone gives us improved functionality over and above what the FDMEE script editor offers us. However, I did mention that there is an additional add-on that we can install to Notepad++ in order to execute our code here, which is a really useful thing to be able to do. And we can access that through the plugins menu here. And when you've installed the 32-bit version of Notepad++, there's a plugin manager that's available, and we can download our plugin directly from here. Now the plugin that we're looking for is one called Python Script, and just by scrolling down the alphabetical list here, you can see that I found it. So I'm going to place a check alongside this plugin. I'll click the install button, and It's actually telling me here that there is an update available for the plugin manager itself. In order to download this plugin, I will need to update the plugin manager. So I'm going to confirm that I want to do that. I'll confirm that I want to restart Notepad++. And then I'll need to run through the installation of that plugin once again. So we run down to the Python script plugin and select it once more, click the install button. This is now downloading and installing that plugin. Okay, so the plugin's installed. I can now say I'm willing to restart Notepad++ by clicking yes there. And I'm now ready to work with that plugin. Now we're going to cover the use of the plugin in much more detail in subsequent sections of the course. But for now, if I come to the plugins menu, you'll see that there's a Python script menu item here. And I could use this to create a new Python script file. Now, although this is called Python script, this actually works for Jython. It saves the files with a .py extension in the same way that the FDME script editor does. But I'll create a new script here called example.py and save it. And I could now begin to write my script here. So I could create a simple variable, a equals 10, b equals 5, and I could have a simple print line saying print a times b. And this will simply execute these three commands in sequence now when I tell this to run. After entering these details, I need to save the script, and I can then execute the script here in Notepad++ in order to see the results. So I can create a new text file to show the results into, and then I can come through the plugins Python script menu path, and I can find my example script and click here to run it. And the output of that script is then shown here. So you see my script simply took the 10, multiplied it by 5, and it's printed the result out to this other text file. Now this is a very trivial example here, but hopefully it indicates to you the real power that Notepad++ and this Python script plugin give you, because it provides you with a really responsive method for getting feedback about the code that you're writing. And as you're looking to develop more and more complex scripts, the ability to validate those details as you go is incredibly useful. So the idea is you could develop your scripts here in Notepad++, and then we could save those back to FDME once we're happy with the code that we've written in order for them to be made live. So I hope you agree that it's a very simple process to find and install Notepad++ along with its Python script plugin, and we'll be making lots of use of this in the subsequent workshops and the subsequent demonstrations to highlight all of the functionality that Jython scripting makes available in FDME.